Yo, I forgot all about Justin Bieber putting out a new track with a new video like almost a week ago at this point. So we gotta get to it. Roll it. Welcome back to the channel, everybody. Channel's name is The Third Ernest. I'm Ernest Adiano the Third, y'all guys' third family. If you're new here and you're not subscribed and you like what you see at the end of the video, consider clicking the subscribe button bottom right hand corner. Now, Justin Bieber is definitely an artist that has grown on me over time. Obviously, I was not really a fan of his work when he was like a preteen and then into his teens, and then he kind of acted like a jackass a little bit, you know, just kind of acting out as you would normally expect from like a child star, basically trying to find who they are. So I couldn't fault him for that, but I was just never really a fan of his music until most recently. Besides the track Yummy Yum, it's like the dude can't miss. Even with that track, he really didn't miss, but it's obviously just not a track that I would be about. But he had the Pop Star music video with Drake, and then he had that most recent track Holy, and then I hear good things about this track and how it's just his music and his personality and his public persona and his marketing and everything about him has matured so much. You know, he's an adult now, he's married. So I respect the fact that as he matures, his music is maturing with him, and it's like he's attracting an older audience now. So I'm about it. Follow your boy on Instagram and on Twitter at The Third Ernest, just like the channel. Links are down in the description below. Video's 5 days old, 22 million views. Let's get it. I assume this is supposed to be him when he was a kid. And I'm sure there's like hella symbolism within this shot right now. Like the white roses symbolize something, the cap symbolizes something. Obviously the hockey stick symbolizes something. This is just a nice shot like coming into, I'm assuming him, and there's nobody else in the room and the song is entitled Lonely. And there's a reason why people say it's lonely at the top. Cause nobody else has the experiences that you have. So you really can't, you can't share that with anybody else.
Everybody knows my name now. But something about it still feels strange. Like looking in a mirror, trying to steady yourself and seeing somebody else. And everything is not the same now. It feels like all our lives have changed. Maybe when I'm older it'll all calm down, but it's killing me now.
Yo, this song is gonna be a powerful ass track, yo. That's exactly what I said. Like, no one can share those experiences with you, so that means like no one can all, like whenever you're going through an internal crisis, like trying to figure out who you are, it's like nobody can help because nobody, there is very few people on this planet that are able to even understand what it's like to live in Justin Timberlake. Him would probably be one of them, but even understand what it's like to live in Justin Bieber's shoes, because that's a life that very few people will ever see. And even his family, like, they love him and they want to support him, but they don't know what he's going through. He said, everybody knows my name, but it feels also strange, like looking in a mirror and trying to steady yourself, but you don't even see yourself, you see somebody else. It's a dope ass lyric, and this is definitely supposed to be him because of that haircut, you can tell. And then obviously Benny comes in like, hey yo, we gotta go, it's time. And all Benny can see is 28 29 30 year old Bieber. He doesn't see that it's just a little kid trying to find himself deep down.
Maybe when I'm older it'll all calm down, but it's killing me now. What if you had it all, but nobody to call? Maybe then you'd know me.
See, that's what I'm talking. I literally just said that. And by the way, this is a dope ass like video so far. A one take video. One take shots are meant to feel immersive. They're recorded as such so that way it feels like you're there. Because if you're there, you can't just cut to the next scene. You can just look around and that's really it. So it's like you're right here with him as he's singing, and as you're seeing this little kid, it's like you're there living the experience with him. Any kind of cut for the video would make that feeling of immersiveness go away. And like I said, he basically said what I just said, that like, what if you had it all, but even though you have it all, you got nobody to call, because even if you did, nobody knows what you're going through. If you lived through that, or if you thought about that, then you'd know my pain. Then you know the life that I live and what I'm going through. That shit is heavy. Maybe then you'd know me. Maybe then you'd feel me. But you won't feel me till everybody say they love you, but it's not love. And you'll sue this.
Maybe then you'd know me. Cause I've had everything, but no one's listening, and that's just fucking lonely. I'm so lonely. Lonely. Everybody knows my past now, like My house was always made of glass. And maybe that's the price you pay for the money and fame at an early age.
Yo, see? So I'm talking about. Like, nobody knows the experience of having your entire past laid out and having your entire past used against you. Like, he was just a kid when he came into the music industry. And kids make mistakes. Kids are going through growing pains. You and I have gone through growing pains, but we have people to relate it with because we have people that we went through those growing pains with. We have family, we have friends, we have cousins, we got, you know, everybody that went through the struggle with you on the way up. But nobody knows Justin Timberlake's struggle as a child because nobody ever could ever relate to what he went through. Nobody ever had the life that he did. And when he says maybe that's the price of fame and the price of success, that is the price of success. The price is that you do feel lonely. The price is that you feel alone because nobody can relate to what you're talking about. The price is that you grew up in front of the entire world's eyes and you made mistakes in front of their eyes and they're always gonna hold that against you.
Maybe that's the price you pay for the money and fame at an early age. And everybody saw me sick, and it felt like no one gave a shit. They criticized the things I did as an idiot kid.
Yep, see? They criticized everything that I did. They saw, and didn't he have like Lyme disease or something? He's like, he was like literally physically ill. Everybody saw me sick, but no one wanted to lend a hand. They just criticized. They just talked about all my past transgressions when I was little, or like when I was young. It's crazy how people don't even realize how lonely the spotlight is until an artist like Justin Bieber puts this type of song out and kind of floors everybody and it takes everybody back. Like, it was right in front of your eyes. You saw the entire thing happen, so why is it that it had to take him putting it out and laying it on a track for you to understand he's a lonely kid that's growing up and making mistakes in front of the entire world?
Things I did as an idiot kid. What if you had it all, but nobody to call? Maybe then you'd know me.
Bro, this shot right here to go from like the buildup, like, hey, yo, you're on stage in 5, like, come on up. And then he coming up, you see like the nervousness in his face. We're following him, we're tracking backwards. And then once he actually walks on stage and then no one's there, that like takes you back. It's like, you're like confused for a second as you're trying to figure out why nobody's there. Whoever directed this, whoever had the vision to make this all one take and then open up to an empty audience, that's fire.
'Cause I've had everything, but no one's listening. And that's just fucking lonely.
And what's crazy about it that I just put it together in my head while I was trying to figure out, like, why is the stadium or why is the playhouse empty? It's empty because even if it was full, he still feels empty inside.
Lonely. I'm so lonely.
And we pull back so we can see how small he is.
Lonely.
Yo. The only person in the stands or in the seats is him as the adult that he is now, looking back on his life. Bro, this shit is deep, son. Yo, the only person that he has to like to sing about his life to is him. Again, no one will go through what he's gone through. So the only person that younger Bieber is singing to, or that older Bieber is singing to, is the opposite version of himself, dog. This is the type of music that I wanna see from Justin Bieber. This is the type of shit that I wanna hear right here. 'Cause this right here is real. And you don't even have to be a multimillionaire. You don't have to be someone at Justin Bieber's level of success, because you're not gonna be someone at Justin Bieber's level of success. That's just the way it is. But this is a completely real feeling that people feel, because a lot of people feel like they're alone in the world. A lot of people feel like they have no one else that can empathize or knows the feeling that they're going through. So they feel just as alone as Justin Bieber does. And that's, yeah, that shit is powerful. It's dope to hear somebody like put their vulnerabilities out on a track like that, because the vulnerabilities and the emotions of the track are what people actually relate to. Like, yeah, this ain't gonna be a radio track. This ain't gonna this ain't gonna be spun by all the hottest VJs and DJs in the world, but this is reality. This is a real ass song. This might be the most emotional song that I've ever heard from Justin Bieber, and it's 2 minutes long. Within the 2 minutes that the track was playing, I got so much like emotion and I got so much out of it, more so than I ever have with any of his other tracks before. Yo, in my personal opinion, best Justin Bieber song that I've ever heard. But yo, that brings us to the end of this video, ladies and gentlemen. If you like what you see, please consider liking the video, leaving a comment down below. Helps the algorithm, helps it, you know, send it out there in the recommended for other people to view. If you like what you see enough, please consider subscribing, because this long form kind of analytical feedback about the video, about the lyrics, about what I'm thinking. That's how we do it on this channel. Follow your boy on Instagram and on Twitter at @TheThirdErnest, just like the channel. The links are down in the description below. Hit up the Discord also down in the description below. But that's all that I got for you today, ladies and gentlemen. I appreciate your time. And like I always say at the end of all of my videos, go out there in the world, love and care for one another, love and care for each other. And I'll catch everybody on the next video. Peace.